to get the 4%, if you had a mixed stock fishery that's limited by the weakest stock, would pass, you know, in case of Skagit had really relatively robust populations, it would pass more of those populations, more than the 50% allowable harvest, into the terminal areas. Those fish can be caught in local terminal fisheries, and that can be tribal fisheries, it could be in-river recreational fisheries, or it could be terminal bay fisheries and on non-treaty commercial fleets. And what you would say, you may see, and in this case, is an increase. That was the ultimate goal, was an increase in the non-treaty commercial efforts to balance that budget. Now, the state's policy has been, in the case of Puget Sound, is to provide a recreational priority for fish like chinooks and coho, recognizing that that generates a higher economic value. And, you know, even though, in this case, if we didn't have the terminal commercial fishery, non-treaty commercial fishery, the tribesmen catch more fish, but by doing so, because we have maximum amount of recreational fishery, we actually get the local value, the generation of the economic value is greater under that scenario than it would be on a strict 50-50. And that's important to a lot of people. And I think it's important to recognize that it's more than just two equal piles of dead fish. It's recognition that different user groups have different values, and we want to address all those values and allow each of the groups to maximize their use of that resource. And one way to do that is local adaptations to each of the fisheries.